They come creeping out of darkness, and to darkness they return. In their wake they leave destruction, where they go no one can learn. For they leave no trace in passing, as if all who watched were blind. Like a dream of evil sending, nightblades passing, nightblades rending, into darkness once more blending, leaving only a dead behind. First a threat and then a death comes in the darkness of the night, and a dozen would-be allies have begun to show their fright. When the nightblades strike unhindered and can take a life at will, there's no safety in alliance and much peril in defiance. It is best to show compliance and the Karsite ranks to fill. The chief envoy summons on you, for one ally still seems brave, and the treaty may be salvaged if Vanyel this life can save. Herald Vanyel feigns refusal, senses one would play him fool, thinks of treachery in hiding, lets his instincts be his guiding, his own counsel he is biding, he'll be no unwitting tool. Garbed in black slips, Harold Vanyel to their last lone allies keep. Over wall and into window, past all gates and guards to creep. Past all gates and guards, no magic has them wrapped in deadly spell. They are drugged and they are dreaming, some foe strike in friendly seeming. See, a metal dart, they're gleaming, Vanyel knows the symptoms well. Now he hears another's footsteps soft before him in the dark, and he hastes to lay an ambush while the nightblade seeks his mark. Now he waits beside the doorway of the ally's very room, and the nightblade all unknowing, with a single lamp beam showing, to a confrontation's going, not to fill another tomb. Out of shadow Vanyel rises, and he bars the nightblade's way. He has only that slim warning, Vanyel has him soon at bay. When the guards have all awakened, and he bears the nightblade's face, and all minds but his are reeling, when he tears off the concealing, and the envoy's face revealing, brings the traitor to disgrace.